Dear brothers and sisters in the Lord Jesus Christ, good day. Today I wish to speak about sinning of a believer. I'm sorry that I need to speak about it, but I see sins in the lives of my fellow believers. If you have given a promise to God, you need to keep your promise. You need to have faith in God. Let us go to Jephthah in Judges. There he promised that he, when he gained the victory over the enemy, the first thing would come out of the city he would sacrifice. Be careful and let there be a lesson in promising something to God. What happened? Jephthah had the victory over the enemy, and the first thing which came, or better, who came out of the city was his only daughter, a virgin still. He had made a promise and he kept his promise. His daughter told him, "Father, keep your promise, but let me weep about my virginity for a few months." He let her weep about her virginity, and thereafter he sacrificed her. Why he sacrificed her, I don't know, because God hated all those foreign people who sacrificed their daughters and sons to the idols. Why he didn't took a replacement sacrifice, I don't know. Let's go to Saul, the king Saul. He was in a battle and he told his army that they were not allowed to eat, but to continue to defeat the enemy. His son Jonathan wasn't present, and when they passed through the forest, his son Jonathan, he saw the honey and he ate from the honey. The army was shocked and told him the promise of his father who would eat today, he would be killed. Under the guidance of Jonathan, they gained the victory. When they returned to King Saul, they told him what had happened, and Saul told his son that he had to be killed. However, the Israelitish people, they said, "No, he guided us to the victory. You are not allowed to kill him." People, God the Father, he is love. He sent his son to earth to die for our sins on the cross. That's the love of God for men. But don't be mistaken, the Bible also tells that God the Father and Jesus Christ will judge about the living, and that are Christians, and the dead, the unbelievers who reject God. God is like a burning fire. He doesn't tolerate sin. He castigates persons, believers, in order that we bear more fruit. So, don't let there be sin in your life. Let's look to Israel. The Israelitish people, they were liberated from Egypt out of the slavery. God has shown his power by the templates. When the Israelitish people passed through the Red Sea, they went on the dry ground, and when the Egyptian army thought, ha, we can pass as well, the water closed and killed the army, the Egyptian army. God showed his power. However, when the Israelitish people arrived at the promised land, they sent 12 spies. 2 spies told the Israelites, we will conquer. However, there were 10 spies telling, no, they are too powerful. And they didn't enter, and God went furious and promised by himself, these people will not enter into the promised land. They will all die and spend 40 years in the desert. They didn't like this punishment of God, and they said, let's go. And they were defeated. A serious lesson we are seeing nowadays, the power of God. Some he saved, others he doesn't save from the COVID. Why, we don't know. But these Israelitish people who were disbelieving, despite they saw the power of God in Egypt, the destruction of the Egypt army, they all had went dead in the desert. A desert for 40 years, very cold in the night, a lot of heat during the daytime, living in tents instead of a welfare in the promised land with all the fruits and good food and beautiful houses. Be careful if you don't believe in God. There's also the disobedience of the Israelitish people. God told about the Sabbath year. 6 years they were allowed to harvest, and in the 7th year they were not allowed to harvest. They were disobedient to this commandment of God, and God sent them for 70 years as a punishment to Babylon. Be careful. I will give you some examples about promises to God or to a person, a believer or not. If you are giving your word, you need to keep your word. Yes is yes, no is no. The first example I will give you is about a person, a Christian. He borrowed 60,000 and he told that he would pay back 600 per month. From this money he bought a car and he became a taxi driver to sustain himself and his wife. His children already had left the house. The first 3 months he paid according to the contract which he signed, the 600. And thereafter, but I need to work 10 hours per day. That's too much. He diminished, and in the end he didn't pay any more the 600 which he had promised to return every month and only work sufficient to sustain himself and his wife. His life, together with his wife, is nowadays terrible. He's hardly earning any money, hardly capable in sustaining himself and his wife. There was a preacher, and there were a lot of problems within his church. He got a prophecy that even if there only were left 4 believers in his church, he needed to continue and trust God. However, and there was a brother in Christ offering him to pay for the rent, the water, the energy, and so on. But he didn't like this brother being dependent upon this brother, and he turned his back and dismissed himself from the church. Look at his life today. No faith in God, not trusting what God is promising. There is a sister in Christ. She heard about that the vaccination killed 3 persons who were vaccinated. She saw also Christians curing from COVID. And now she is telling and forcing other brothers and sisters to be vaccinated. I'm seeing Christians, they had COVID and still they take the vaccination. A few days ago I saw a Dutch examination, microscopic. They examined 4 vaccinations and they discovered the terrible things in those 4 vaccinations. They are secret and protected by patent. They are not telling these ingredients of the vaccination to the World Health Organization because they are protected by the patent. Those ingredients, they might kill. They are poisonous. And this sister and other Christians, after being cured by God from COVID, she is telling, get vaccinated. A severe sin. Those Israelitish people who didn't go and entered into the promised land, first being cured by God from COVID and thereafter trusting the vaccination. If that vaccination wouldn't kill you, but protect you. But the first, the second, the third vaccination, where is the end? How can you put your trust? And how can you force and tell as a sister in Christ to be vaccinated? Severe sin. Look to her life, a misery, not blessed by God, disobedience to God, not trusting God. How was it with Father Abraham? He was told that through his son Isaac, he would have a great nation. And still, God told him to sacrifice his son. And he told by himself, God had promised me a great nation through my son. And in obedience, he went to sacrifice his son. The journey took him 3 days, so he had 3 days to repent. But he continued, and when he wanted to kill his son to be sacrificed on the altar, God stopped him. Faith, trusting God, being blessed by God. But when you are sinning, not keeping your promises, not keeping your promises, not trusting God, God is punishing the Christians. Brothers and sisters, let us be wise. And I'm weeping about all those Christians I'm seeing which are living in misery and who are not blessed. If you see a sister or brother not blessed by God, and you know that there is sin in their life, go to talk to her or him. Send the link of this video to her or him, and let's pray. Because I'm seeing also the stubbornness not to recognize, not going on their knees and begging God for forgiveness. We can't help those brother or sister. The only way is that we pray if they are not willing to listen, if they remain in stubbornness. But I can't promise that they will be saved out of their poverty, like those Israelites who didn't enter the promised land. They were punished by God for 40 years in the desert, in the cold nights, the heat, during daytime, but in the end they died in the desert. Don't provocate God. God the Father and Jesus Christ, please open our eyes. Open all those Christians, believers, who are stubborn, who don't realize, or perhaps they realize very well, how they are sinning, how they are putting their trust in human. Please forgive and help them, save them before it is too late. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. May God the Father and Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit convince you of sin and help you and show you the way out. I bless you in the name of God. Amen.